Well, good morning, everyone. Shall we begin? Welcome to our service at Paint Branch Unitarian Universalist Church. You know, we've been experimenting with having your videos on or not on, and I see today that I must have left the setting on the Zoom room to have your video off when you arrived at this service this morning. You're welcome to turn your own video on again. I know a lot of people like to see the faces of people who've come to church this morning. So feel free to do it in any way, whatever way works well for you. We are now going to mute everybody so that we can do the service without extraneous noise. I think a tractor just drove by my house and you might be hearing tractor noise coming through what I'm saying today. But we will begin the service this morning with a prelude played by David Chapman, our music director, Bridge Over Troubled Waters by Paul Simon. David?
Good morning, and welcome to the virtual Sunday service of Paint Branch Unitarian Universalist Church. What a joy it is to gather online to create a community and to support one another on life's journey. My name is Susannah Schiller, and I'm one of seven worship associates, lay members who collaborate with our minister, Rachel Christensen, and other service leaders on Sunday services. Whoever you are, wherever you are on life's journey, you are welcome here. Whether you logged in on your iPhone, your Android, or your laptop, you are welcome here. Whether you're straight, gay, bi, questioning, trans, old, young, of a certain age, you are welcome here. Whatever your race, color, ethnicity, gender, political beliefs, gifts, you are welcome here. We are a community striving to live our Unitarian Universalist principles as individuals and as a congregation. We welcome those already here and those still to arrive. Before we move into worship, make sure you know how to use Zoom. Find that mute button, the microphone icon, and make sure that you are muted. And bring up your chat screen. The bubble for your chat screen is in different places, depending on what type of device you are using. In chat, please say how many people are in attendance via your connection. One, if it's just you. That way we can get a sense of how many are attending the service today. And if you're visiting us for the first or second time and are willing, post who you are in the chat and provide contact information there if you're willing to be contacted. After the service, we will have a coffee hour breakout rooms again. Stay on Zoom and you'll be grouped at random with several other participants. Enjoy visiting with them. And now I have a few announcements. Our annual meeting for Paint Branch will be held on Sunday, June 14th, that's next Sunday, using Zoom from noon to 2. We will be using the waiting room feature so that we can document who arrives into the meeting for quorum and voting purposes. This will take a little time, so please plan on arriving early. Arriving at 11:30 is not too soon. We will be using an online voting system to vote for board members, nominating committee, and legacy fund members. Details about the meeting and voting will be available this week, and a link to it is posted on the calendar entry on the website. Will all those members who seek to be delegates to this year's General Assembly please send or resend their requests to Denominational Affairs Chair Don Gersten. In order to assess the congregation's readiness and capacity for a capital campaign to fund a new deck and entrance, Stewardship for Us consultant Barry Finkelstein will hold multiple group meetings and interviews via Zoom over the course of 2 weeks in June. These will culminate in an open facilitated workshop for the entire congregation on Saturday, June 20th at 10:30 in the morning, and an open forum after service on Sunday, June 21st, where Barry will present observations and recommendations. The Capital Campaign team will be reaching out to individuals and groups to ask for their participation in one of the many small group discussions. For more information, contact Don Gersten or Renee Katz. The Social Action Committee is having a special collection this Sunday for Crop Walk, which helps those who are being challenged by disease and hunger. If you'd like to participate in a virtual walk, please take a picture and submit it to the church's Facebook page or email Kathy Bartolomeo. Let SAC know if you donated and how much, so we'll be able to track Paint Branch's support for the special collection organizations. And now, Sharon Werth will introduce our first dance.
In this unusual time in our congregation's history, we wondered if there could even be a dance service. Although the Chalice dancers have continued to meet virtually on Saturday mornings, we could not rehearse together. We were inspired by the many artistic endeavors on social media that illustrate how we can either be held back by what we can't do or imagine what is possible. We offer you Moving from the Inside, Reshaping the Future. We will slowly emerge from our homes and the world we enter will be different. Instead of getting back to normal, can we imagine a future that has us living our values in new and better ways? Please be sure that your setting is on speaker view. The first dance we share with you this morning is the Pieta, choreographed in 1941 by Erika, Thimey, and performed by University of Maryland dance student Miejo, Dambita. As an introduction to this piece, I would like to share an excerpt from a writing by J. Ruth Gendler. One day, at the edge of the forest, grief heard another woman crying out. She spoke with her. She listened to her story. Grief was surprised. She had never met anyone else who had suffered as she had. Together, the women sat in the clearing and mourned their children. Through the long afternoon, through the twilight, through the night, they wept and wept and wept and wept. In the morning, grief was washed of her tears. She came to our town and started to do her real work. We present the Pieta.
How about now? I'm unmuted now. I tried twice. Thank you for bringing that dance to us this morning, Sharon. We are, so many of us, experiencing so much grief in this time, in this period. Dance and the arts are a way, ways to experience and express the reality of our lives and to process the things that are happening in our world. On Thursday, I participated in a vigil at University Christian Church in Hyattsville, where maybe 300 people gathered to protest the ongoing police violence against people of color and Black men in particular. Several Paint Branch folks were there. I was honored to be one of several clergy to speak and to call upon the gathered group to hold our legislators accountable, to stand with those of color in this work, and to refuse to be silent. All too often, as white people, we have become engaged in this issue only to fall away as the weeks and the months go on. This appears to be a new opportunity, a sustained anger and commitment that seems to be displaying itself across the country and across the world in small towns and large cities. We are calling upon our communities to make a real change, to demand training on racism, on implicit bias, on de-escalation, on engagement. Because we need our police to be in partnership with our communities and not, as Mr. Trump says, in domination of our communities. There was the video in Buffalo that you may have seen where a 75-year-old man was knocked down by the police. Two members of that police force were fired or suspended the next day. And at that point, 57 members of their riot control division all resigned at once, saying those men were not doing anything wrong. They were doing what they were trained to do and what they were asked to do. Clearly, we need to change how our police are trained and what they are being asked to do. We grieve the death of George Floyd, Breonna Taylor, and hundreds of others who have died wrongfully at the hands of the police in the last several years. The Pieta is an expression of grief, and for me today, an expression of that grief. Thank you for bringing it to us today. We are called to not be silent any longer, not today, not tomorrow, not ever. The Chalice dancers and the Erika Thimey Dance and Theater Company have choreographed and will now perform this next piece as I read the poem. And the People Stayed Home by Kitty O'Mara. And the people stayed home and read books and listened and rested and exercised and made art and played games and learned new ways of being and were still and listened more deeply. Some meditated, some prayed, some danced, some met their shadows, and the people began to think differently, and the people healed. And in the absence of people living in ignorant, dangerous, mindless, and heartless ways, the earth began to heal. And when the danger passed and the people joined together again, they grieved their losses and made new choices and dreamed new images and created new ways to live and heal the earth fully. As they had been healed. Amen.
Because this service is so visual, I'd like to encourage everyone to set Zoom on speaker rather than gallery if you haven't already done so. Now, I will light my virtual chalice. There we go. Let us say the chalice lighting words together. We light the chalice to celebrate Unitarian Universalism. This is the Church of the Open Mind. The helping hands, the loving heart, and the radiant spirit. Encendamos esta chalice para celebrar el unitarismo universalismo. Esta es la iglesia de la mente abierta, de las manos amigas, del amor del corazón y del espíritu radiante. And please put your microphones on mute. I love that poem that we just heard by Kitty O'Meara. It's so full of hope for our future. Hope that we will learn from this strange time that we are going through and shape a better future as a result. We're certainly learning how to communicate with friends and family from afar, which is closing the distance between people who really are physically far apart. I just met with a group of women I got to know here at Paint Branch in the 90s because we were mothers of young children. We used to meet in person, but we don't all live in the area anymore. Now we're thinking of more regular meetings because we've discovered that a virtual gathering is almost as good as the real thing. On the flip side, doing the monthly neighborhood book club via Zoom feels really weird, knowing the people in the little pictures on my iPad are literally next door and across the street. We're taking back the streets from our cars. Cities are closing downtown streets to make space for people to walk and restaurants to offer outside seating. I feel safer bicycling on roads near my home than I ever did before because there just isn't as much traffic. And the air is noticeably clearer. But we don't seem to be learning how to be kinder to each other. The social distancing makes it even harder to listen deeply to different perspectives. Isolated in our houses, we stay in our own news echo chambers and to talk past each other, rather like the way mild-mannered people become aggressive drivers on the beltway because we're hidden from each other in our own cars. The political rhetoric is filled with finger-pointing and name-calling. Black people are still being killed by police and trigger-happy civilians for no reason at an alarming rate. We've had almost 2 weeks now of nationwide, multiracial, multi-age protests reacting to the most recent events in the nation's long-running social injustice saga and inflamed by record unemployment and fear stemming from the pandemic. I feel helpless in the face of these big issues. I want to suggest solutions, but I don't have any. Now more than ever, I need to heed the words of this poem. Listen more deeply. Meditate. Pray. Dance. Think differently. That when we join together again, we might make new choices and create new ways to live. Now Jessica Sharp will sing This Little Light of Mine.
Thank you, Susannah. Please sing along if you're able. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Everywhere I go, everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine. Everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine. Everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Now building up a world, building up a world, I'm gonna let it shine. Building up a world, I'm gonna let it shine. Building up a world, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
Thank you, Jessica. Christine Walters-Paintner is an American poet and writer living in Galway, Ireland. She is the author of 12 books of nonfiction on creative process and contemplative practice, and her poems have been published in several journals in both the US and Ireland. She says, "I come most alive in that fertile space where the inner monk and artist meet and dance together." We'll now begin her story, Song for the Pandemic.
Praise be the nurses and doctors, every medical staff bent over flesh to offer care, for lives saved and lives lost, for showing up either way. Praise for the farmers tilling soil, planting seeds so food can grow, an act of hope if ever there was. Praise be the janitors and garbage collectors, the grocery store clerks and the truck drivers barreling through long, quiet nights. Give thanks for bus drivers, delivery persons, postal workers, and all those keeping an eye on water, gas, and electricity. Blessings on our leaders making hard choices for the common good, offering words of assurance. Celebrate the scientists working a way to understand the thing that plagues us, to find an antidote, and all the medicine makers. Praise be the journalists keeping us informed. Praise be the teachers, finding new ways to educate children from afar, and blessings on parents holding it together for them. Blessed are the elderly and those with weakened immune systems, all those who worry for their health. Praise for those who stay at home to protect them. Blessed are the domestic violence victims on lockdown with abusers, the homeless and refugees. Praise for the artists and poets, the singers and storytellers, all those who nourish with words and sound and color. Blessed are the ministers and therapists of every kind, bringing words of comfort. Blessed are the ones whose jobs are lost, who have no savings, who feel fear of the unknown gnawing. Blessed are those in grief, especially who mourn alone. Blessed are those who have passed into the great night. Praise for police and firefighters, paramedics, and all who work to keep us safe. Praise for all the workers and caregivers of every kind. Praise for the sound of notifications, messages from friends reaching across the distance. Give thanks for laughter and kindness. Praise be our four-footed companions with no forethought or anxiety, responding only in love. Praise for the seas and rivers, forests and stones who teach us to endure. Give thanks for your ancestors, for the wars and plagues they endured and survived. Their resilience is in your bones, your blood. Blessed is the water that flows over our hands and the soap that helps keep them clean each time a baptism. Praise every moment of stillness and silence so new voices can be heard. Praise the chance and slowness. Praise be the birds who continue to sing the sky awake each day. Praise for the primrose poking yellow petals from dark earth. Blessed is the air clearing overhead so one day we can breathe deeply again. And when this has passed, may we say that love spread more quickly than any virus ever could. May we say this was not just an ending, but also a place to begin.
And now, let us join our hearts and minds in a time of prayer and meditation. As we gather in community, we carry with us life's hurts and its great joys. Sometimes sharing these joys and concerns in community can help. Now, while we listen to David play Somewhere Over the Rainbow, I encourage you to submit your joys and sorrows by entering them into the chat bar. Thank you. Let us take a moment to acknowledge all that has been shared, as well as those joys and sorrows that remain unspoken and yet are on our minds and in our hearts. May we hold all these and one another in love and kindness so that this congregation may be a source of strength and comfort, courage and hope in the days and weeks ahead. Next, we have a dance performed by the Chalice dancers at the 2014 dance service, We Shall Overcome.
Thank you. And now, a poem from poet and activist Sonia Renee Taylor. We will not go back to normal. Normal never was. We will not go back to normal. Normal never was. Our pre-corona existence was not normal other than that we normalized greed, inequality, exhaustion, depletion, extraction, disconnection, confusion, rage, hoarding, hate, and lack. We should not long to return, my friends. We should not long to return. We are being given the opportunity to stitch a new garment, one that fits all of humanity and nature. We will not go back to normal. And now the Chalice dancers in a 2010 auction dance to Sam Cooke's A Change Is Gonna Come.
That we do in living out our Unitarian Universalist values within this congregation and in the world is only possible through the generosity of our members and friends. This Sunday's offering will be received using our Breeze online donation page, or it can be mailed to the church. And now we'll listen to Renee Katz singing Calling All Angels.
I need a sign to let me know you're here. So all of these lines are being crossed over the atmosphere. I need to know that things are gonna look up. 'Cause I feel us drowning in a sea spill from a cup. When there is no place left, no safe place to put my head. You can feel the world shake from the words that are said. And I'm calling all angels. I'm calling all you angels. Now I won't give up if you don't give up. I won't give up if you don't give up. I won't give up if you don't give up. I won't give up if you don't give up. I need a sign to let me know you're here. 'Cause my TV set just keeps it all from being clear. I want a reason for the way things have to be. I need a hand to help build up some kind of hope inside of me. And I'm calling all angels.
Karen?
Okay, thank you. Good morning, Karen Lee Scrivo, honored to be your affiliated community minister for social justice. What a week it has been, and it is so good to be with all of you in community here this morning. I wanted to share a short reflection of the week with you. I can't breathe. Those were among the last words of George Floyd, a black man who died with a white police officer's knee on his neck for 8 minutes and 46 seconds, while three other officers looked on. I can't breathe. These are the words of people in the grips of the coronavirus that has disproportionately killed more Black, Indigenous, and people of color in this country. It is the lack of breath that ties together these pandemics. I can't breathe. These are the words of too many unarmed Black people who have died at the hands of police. Eric Gardner, Breonna Taylor, Ahmed Arbery, Tony McDade, Sandra Bland, Trayvon Martin, Michael Brown, Tamar Rice, and far, far too many others. I can't breathe. These are the words from those who have died from the coronavirus. Black and brown mothers, fathers, sisters, brothers, aunts, uncles, nieces, nephews, neighbors, friends, and co-workers died too soon and often died alone. I can't breathe. These are the words of people protesting across this country, those who have had enough of police brutality and over-policing of communities of color, people who have had enough of systemic racism, people of all ages, colors, income levels, positions, protesting in big cities, the suburbs, small towns, and farmlands in all 50 states. Time's up for racism. Let us pause a moment and together take three healing breaths. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. And now join me in a time of prayer and meditation. Breath of life, spirit of love and light that moves in us and among us. Today we lift up all those who have died because of the color of their skin. We won't be quiet anymore. This has gone on far, far too long. With all the breath that is in us, let us join others fighting systemic racism and white supremacy. May we each find what is ours to do, and may we remain faithful to our task, both now and in the days to come. Amen, and may it be so. It is often said that the first step to change is imagining something different. One of the first dances I participated in as a Chalice dancer was Imagine, created during the Arts and Worship Workshop in 2018 and inspired by the words and music of John Lennon. We can't offer that in person this morning, but we're happy to share this 2019 video of our Dancing It with the Erika, Thimey dance and theater members at the North Chevy Chase Christian Church.
Thank you.
I'm so grateful you were able to be here with us today for this dance service. It's wonderful to have you join us. There's going to be one more movement thing, and it will be enhanced if you can follow a few directions. For those of you who are have stopped your video and are not visible on the screen, I encourage you to probably go down to the bottom of your screen, although it's in different places on different devices, and you might find the camera, and it has, if it has a red X through it, click on it so that it turns on your video. It's not happening right away, but pretty soon we're going to do something that it would be just wonderful to have you all on video at that point. Thank you for being with us today. Please join me and particularly Mary Rooker as she sings and signs Spirit of Life. Keep yourself muted, but we invite you to sing along. Mary, are you out there?
Yes, I'm just not sure why I'm not in speaker view.
Well, you don't, you're fine.
Oh, there,
it's just
there
on your device, not on ours. You're okay. Ready to go.
Okay. And I invite you to allow the Spirit of Life to flow through you as we sing together. Spirit of Life, come unto me, sing in my heart all the stirrings of compassion, blow in the wind, rise in the sea. Move in the hand, giving life shape of justice. Roots hold me close, wings set me free. Spirit of Life, come to me, come to me.
Thank you, Mary. And now I will extinguish the virtual chalice. And turn over the postlude to our chalice dancers and the congregation, and Jessica.
We invite you to join us for the postlude. Please change your screens to gallery view. I'll give you a moment. You may stand if you are willing and able, or stay seated. If you stand, we suggest you move back a few steps for better screen view, and that you go to page one of your gallery view, if you're not there, and follow any dancer, any chalice dancer in a red top. We present I Am Light, written by India Ari, and Jessica Sharp is our vocalist.
I am light, I am light. I am light, I am light. I am light, I am light. things my family did. I am not the voices in my head. I am not the pieces of the brokenness inside. I am light. 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 I'm not the mistakes that I have made, or any of the things that caused me pain. I am not the pieces of the dream I left behind. I am light. 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 I am not the color of my eyes. I am not the skin on the outside. I am not my age. I am not my race. My soul inside is all light, all light. It's all light, all light. I am light, I am light. I defined. I am a god on the inside. I am a star, a piece of it all.
Thank you, everyone, for being willing to play a little and experiment with our dance service. I'm going to set up breakout rooms. I encourage you to accept the invitation to go to one and say hello to folks. Thank you so much.